present, the world has to encounter the problems of climate change, environmental degradation, disasters, and epidemics of emerging and re-emerging diseases, which are common health problems of many countries. For Thailand, the guidelines for responding to both groups of diseases affecting people's health have been developed, including the systems for disease surveillance, prevention, treatment, and control under the One Health concept. For example, working collaboratively in a multidisciplinary manner among officials in the human and animal health, as well as environmental sectors. Moreover, actions are ongoing regarding the development of capacity and preparedness of the management system, as well as personnel and knowledge management, for efficiently preventing and controlling communicable or infectious diseases according to the internationally recognized standards. Migrant health volunteers, the key to success. Saving the seafood kitchen of the world from severe diarrhea. Samut Sakhon is a small province located at the mouth of the Tha Tien River, just 2 kilometers from the sea and about 30 kilometers west of Bangkok. The province is prosperous with lots of fishery, agro-industrial and tourism industries, as per its provincial slogan of Fishing City, Factory Town, Agricultural Ground and Historic Site. During the 2011 flood crisis in Samut Sakhon, all its 3 districts were declared disaster zones, and a provincial war room was established to monitor the situations, and a public health emergency response command center was also set up. Flooding can cause a widespread or outbreak of severe diarrhea. Samut Sakhon is an area with reports of confirmed cases of severe diarrhea every year and has a large population of migrant workers at risk of a diarrhea outbreak. Therefore, the Provincial Surveillance and Rapid Response Team, SRRT, of the Samut Sakhon Provincial Public Health Office, together with other relevant agencies at all levels, has set up the Diarrhea Surveillance System to continuously work on this matter. Dr. Chairat Wedpanit, Provincial Chief Medical Officer, Samut Sakhon Provincial Public Health Office, said, "The lessons learned in the past diarrhea control efforts had to be used during the flood crisis so that we could successfully control the outbreak in our province. This is an important case study." After the flood crisis, the disease surveillance, screening, and referral systems have been continued with the key workforce of migrant health volunteers, MHVs, who serve as the knowledge bridge between health officials and migrant workers regarding personal hygiene and disease prevention and control practices. These people are the products of the Migrant Health Volunteers Training Center, located at Ban Kham Pra Sub-District Health Promoting Hospital, which focuses on providing the volunteers with knowledge and skills in dealing basic health care and disease prevention and control including the methods of transferring such knowledge and skills to other migrant workers. Migrant health services also cover the migrants' children, so a proactive approach is adopted. Today, health officials from Ban Kampa Sub-District Health Promoting Hospital, together with migrant health volunteers, are providing health services including polio vaccinations at Wat Si Sutaram School, where there are a lot of students who are migrant workers' children. And then at the informal learning center for foreign children in the Klo Krak Nai community, apart from giving polio vaccinations, today a health communication and demonstration session is held on diarrhea prevention and hand washing for the teachers and children. Kong Jit Pon In, director of Ban Kampa Sub-District Health Promoting Hospital, said, regarding health promotion and disease prevention, the health sector cannot do that by itself, as the provincial area is huge and the migrant population is larger than the Thai population. Thus, partners or foreign volunteers who can listen and speak the Thai language are required to serve as migrant leaders or volunteers on this matter. The selected volunteers have been trained in infectious and chronic diseases so that they could pass on the information or knowledge to other foreign migrants. Cooperation is also requested from Thai business operators to allow migrant health volunteers to educate migrant workers about health and hygiene, especially maternal and child health, how to buy or select hygienic foods, environmental sanitation improvements, consumption of newly cooked food, and hand washing before eating a meal. Katlai and Sapa are migrant health volunteers of Burmese and Mon ethnic origins, respectively. Both can speak Thai fluently. Katlai said that, with her personal interest in learning about diseases, when invited by the health official to join the health volunteer training, she decided to do on a trial basis. Seeing the usefulness of the program, she decided to work as a volunteer to help other Burmese fellows. Initially, her work was not well accepted, but now, wherever she goes, there are a lot of people who recognize and trust her. Some call her doctor or healer and ask for advice and help if they have any health problems. Sapa said that the factory at which she works selected her to undergo the health volunteer training. It was a good opportunity to gain health knowledge for further educating others in her community, as some of her community members do not know about hygiene or self-health care. Working for others' benefits has made her feel very proud of herself. even though there are difficulties, problems, and obstacles. Working systematically through multi-sectoral cooperation with the provincial, district, and sub-district level agencies, as well as local government organizations, private sector businesses, non-governmental organizations, and Thai and foreign health volunteers, has narrowed the communication gaps and increased the efficiency of disease prevention and control in a concrete manner.